our service is brief with a short meditation from me because we're gathering in Africville for a special commemoration of the lives lost in the Middle Passage during the transatlantic slave trade. I hope you enjoy this brief service. Thank you. To worship this morning comes from Psalm 5. Listen to my words, Lord. Consider my lament. Hear my cry for help, my King and my God, for to you I pray. In the morning, Lord, you hear my voice. In the morning, I lay my request before you and wait expectantly. Surely, Lord, you bless the righteous. You surround them with your favor as with a shield. Let us pray. Holy and gracious God, we come before you waiting expectantly. We declare, God, that you are our God and we are your people. We gather today, O Lord, to lift up your name, to glorify you. And Lord God, our prayer is that you would be pleased with our praise today. We thank you, Lord, for giving us another time of worship. And we pray, Lord God, that your presence will be felt by all who are engaged, that, Lord, you would move from heart to heart and mind to mind wherever we are. Let your presence be felt. Let your glory fill each dwelling. And especially, Lord, let your glory fill our hearts. Have your way in us and through us. In the name of Christ Jesus, amen.
Awesome.
Welcome, church and friends. You are gathering with us here at New Horizons Baptist Church, where we believe we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. And we always say to our visitors that we pray that a little bit of that empowering strength rub off on you because you've chosen to worship with us today. I'm Dr. Rhonda Britton, the pastor of this wonderful congregation, and we invite you to please visit with us anytime you find yourself in the Halifax area, or visit with us here online watching one of our worship videos. I also want to remind those who are local that we are gathering today at 11 a.m. in Africville. Today we are commemorating lives lost in the Middle Passage during the transatlantic slave trade. And so we are gathering in Africville for a special service, and we invite you to join us there. Thank you for your faithfulness in supporting us all during this pandemic, not only by your watching, but with your gifts. We are in this building campaign, and as we come upon different obstacles, it gets dragged out a little longer than we expected. But we are praying to God that we are back in our church building by the end of this year. Thank you for your gifts that are helping to make it possible. Thank you for your faithfulness, and our prayer is that you would continue to support us so that we can make this a reality. Speaking of gifts, I'm going to invite you now to prepare yourselves to bring an offering to the Lord, remembering that giving is a part of our worship, and we give back to God just a portion of that with which God has prospered us. Let's pray together. Lord God, we thank you for the opportunity to give, and our prayer is, Lord, that you would continue to teach us how to give. We ask you to bless every gift and every giver, and we pray, Lord God, that we would be good stewards here at New Horizons as we receive these gifts. May they be used to the building of your kingdom here on earth. We pray for those who desire to give but do not have it, and we ask, Lord, that you bless them in a way that they will have it the next time. Thank you for your faithfulness towards us. Our desire, Lord, is to be a faithful people. Teach us, Lord God, how to have generous spirits. In the name of Christ Jesus, amen.
Nobody knows the trouble. troubles I see. Glory, hallelujah. Sometimes I'm up, sometimes I'm down. Glory,
Church, I want to remind you that this is AUBA Sunday, August 22nd, and so at 3 p.m. today, the AUBA annual service will be posted on the Black Cultural Center for Nova Scotia's YouTube channel and also on our New Horizons YouTube channel. We plan to have the service to air on Eastlink sometime in the future, hopefully next week. We will let you know. But please be mindful of the announcements that come out during the week. We are also very grateful that we have a church here in Halifax that's been supporting us throughout this pandemic. And so on next Sunday, which is August 29th, we will be back in St. Matthew's United Church on Barrington Street for our worship service at 12 noon. August 29th is Missions Sunday. So we're asking you to bring a special gift for missions. And we will hear from Reverend Grace Skeer, who's bringing the message to us next Sunday. So we'll see you in St. Matthew's on next Sunday, August 29th. I also want to thank those of you who tuned in to our Oasis Assembly this year. As I moderated that session as the president of the CBAC, now the past president. And so I want to thank you for your support of our anti-racism panel discussion that we had on Thursday night and for your attention during OASIS. If you go to the baptist-atlantic.ca website, Canadian Baptists of Atlantic Canada, if you can't remember anything else, just type that in. Then you will be able to view the anti-Black racism panel, hear our voices. It is posted on the website. And you will also be able to order the other messages that happened during the weekend from our guest speaker, Danielle Strickland. Okay, and we had some great music too, so you will thoroughly enjoy that. Thank you for your attention to these matters. Turn your attention now to Psalm 137, verses 1 to 4. Hear the word of the Lord. By the rivers of Babylon, we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. There on the poplars, we hung our harps, for there our captors asked us for songs. Our tormentors demanded songs of joy. They said, "Sing us one of the songs of Zion." How can we sing the songs of the Lord while in a foreign land? The Old King James Version translates, in a strange land. Yeah, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I invite you to meditate with me for just a few moments on this scripture and the topic, make him known. Make him known. Let us pray. Lord God, now in this moment of proclamation, we invite you to open up this word to our understanding, and we thank you that you care enough to send us a word. Our prayer is that it will take root in us and bring forth fruit. Let me decrease now so that you would increase, and the word come forth as you would have it. In the name of Christ Jesus, amen. How do you witness God to your family and friends? How do you make him known to those who do not know? This psalm highlights the time when the Israelites were in exile in Babylon. Their cities had been pillaged and they'd been taken into captivity. What may be surprising to some is that God let it happen. God used their enemies for God's purposes. They had become faithless and idolatrous, disobedient to God, forgetting what they had been taught, forgetting their covenant relationship, forgetting who they were and whose they were. So God allowed their enemies to defeat them, to sack the temple, and to tear up Jerusalem. The things that we face in life are sometimes the natural consequences of our actions, of bad decisions that we make. But sometimes God uses the evil plans of men to wake us up and cause us to come to ourselves. Sometimes God takes the evil that people devise and works it to our good. And sometimes God uses man's evil as a witness to others and an arrow pointing the way to God. We will not know until eternity why God permitted the brutality and slaughter of our people. We will not know until eternity what God's purposes are and how God's purposes have been served in the enslavement of our ancestors. We will not know until eternity what God has done through the lives lost in this slavery, this Black Holocaust. But today, we remember and we honor our ancestors. Today, we remember and honor the lives lost in the Middle Passage. It marks a time when greed and evil met and visited atrocities on people who looked different, whose culture was different, and who were trusting and kind, hospitable even to strangers who meant them no good. Today, we mark the time when the evil machinations of humanity knew no bounds, and that evil was visited upon our ancestors. Today, we mark the time when our people were bound and chained and dragged across land and ocean, treated worse than animals, and then were sold and bought as possessions, their very humanity denied. Put on ships to cross waters they had never ventured into. Dazed, confused, frightened, not even able to conceive of such events. Lives suddenly interrupted and altered for all time. Dragged across land and ocean to other shores, to a strange land. A strange land, the bowels of a ship, a strange land, white faces speaking a foreign tongue, a strange land, cruelty they had never known. Today, centuries later, we find ourselves sometimes feeling like we are still in a strange land. Today, centuries later, we are still struggling to be free, to be recognized as human, to be treated with equity. How can we sing the songs of Zion in a strange land? I just want to give you this short message today, church, to remind you that it is in a strange land that we become witnesses of the true and living God that people do not know. It is in a strange land that we must lift up praise to God. It is in our times of deep disappointment, deep dismay, deep distress, that we must summon the praise from within. Deep calls unto deep. God is spirit, and we must worship him in spirit and in truth. It is easy to praise God in friendly territory. Anybody can praise God when things are going their way, when we feel good about our lives and we feel good about what's happening in the world. Anybody can praise God when they're not met with any strife or struggle or trouble. Anybody can praise God when all the good things of life are being experienced and we're able to hold off the bad. Anybody can praise God when everything's going their way. But a faithful witness has to be able to praise God in the crucible, in a time of oppression. That is when we must praise the Lord. It is in the time of marginalization when we must praise the Lord. It is in the time of, in the face of racist attitudes, that we must praise the Lord. It is under the threat of disenfranchisement that we must praise the Lord. It is in spite of racial profiling that we must praise the Lord. It is when our government officials are not listening to us, when they do not see us, when they do not hear us, when they do not care, that we must continue to praise the Lord. When we are in the strange land of not being seen, that is when we lift up our praise. In the strange land of otherness, when people do not recognize us as human, when people do not see who we are on the inside, when people cast their judgments on us by the color of our skin, when people don't care to get to know us, all they know is we are different. It is in the strange time when they don't see us that we remember we serve El Roy, the God who sees me and sees you. Today, centuries later, the voices and blood of our ancestors call out to remind us of their sacrifices so we may be encouraged. Deep calls unto deep. From the waters, they cry out and remind us that we are a proud and dignified and brilliant people. And in this land where we find ourselves today, we sing, we pray, we cry out. Our souls cry, our souls shout, hallelujah. Church, witnesses of Christ Jesus, witnesses of God's grace and mercy, witnesses of the goodness of God, witnesses of the faithfulness of God, cannot just praise God in the good times, and we cannot just praise God among his people. We must praise God in the places where God is not known. We are the ancestors to the generations coming behind us. We are the voices of the past to those who are in the future. And in the place where people do not know, we are the ones called to make him known. Amen. Now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before his presence in glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power from this time forth and even forevermore. Amen.